Hall number 4 is framed by beautiful wooded areas located up the right side and around this challenging hole. Your tee shot is played across a narrow stream onto a generous elevated landing area. The challenge is to stay clear of the stream, which runs parallel up the right side of the hole, nearly to the green. Several bunkers were placed up the right side to capture the misplaced shot. Your approach shot will be a short one, but must be precise to avoid the bunkers, which were placed around the small green. If you have an admirable short game, you can easily end up with a birdie on this hole. The ninth hole brings you back to the clubhouse with a short dogleg to the right that plays uphill and through woods to an elevated green. The right side of the fairway is heavily bunkered at the dogleg to discourage most players from trying to cut the corner. Don't wager too much on this hole. A par may not be a good enough score to win this hole most of the time. This is the longest par 4 on the course at 477 yards. On most days, this hole will play less than its yardage, as tees are elevated and the entire hole plays slightly downhill. The woods of beautiful and mature trees border and visually frame the hole from the landing area to the green. A long and reasonably straight tee shot is required if the second shot is going to reach the green. An almost 200-yard carry over wetlands off the tee is more than enough for one to think about as you begin the home hole. But once you've survived the initial wetlands, your second shot on this dogleg left will still be a challenge. Make sure that you take enough club to attempt your approach shot over a second wetlands area, uphill to this well-bunkered green tucked into the hillside behind the clubhouse. Many wagers and matches will be won and lost on this finishing hole.